What's up, guys? It's Nick here. We were in the process of making our Cornerstone Element tutorial videos, and we noticed that we didn't cover the basics ID, class, and style, which are congruent between all of the Cornerstone elements. And so we decided that these deserve their own video. So this video is just to get back to the basics and teach you guys about ID, class, and style, the differences between them, and why they're useful. Enjoy! Okay, so we're going to be starting off with ID. To be honest, of these three, ID is the one that I use the least, however it's still important to know what it does. Now starting out, my main confusion was what's the difference between ID and class? And the answer to that is you should really only use ID once per page. So I'm just going to start out by grabbing this headline, and the reason that I'd attach an ID to this is if I wanted to edit this specific element and only that element inside of a custom CSS interface. So since it is unique to this element, you'd probably want to use a selector that you feel is memorable and describes the element that you're editing. So I'm just going to type ID headline. Perfect. As I said before, this value should be unique to that headline. So if I make another headline, I won't want to go and attach the same value to the ID in that next headline. Now, most modern browsers will actually just select your multiple IDs as a list. However, according to CSS syntax, that should break the browser. So if someone's using an outdated browser and you attach the same ID to multiple elements, it will break it. The other difference between ID and class is the way you select them inside of your custom CSS interface. So I'm just going to pop that open, scroll up here. So you select IDs with the hash or pound sign. So I'm going to type pound ID headline, and that was the ID that I selected. And I'm just going to change the color to blue. And boom, there we go. That's really the main difference between class and ID, is you select classes with a period and IDs with a hash or a pound sign. Now I find myself using class a ton in Cornerstone, and this one's extremely useful for multiple reasons, and I'm going to go over all of those in this video. And I'm going to start out with the difference between ID and class. And class allows you to select multiple elements. So what if I want to add the same class to all three of these so I can easily just select the headlines? It's pretty straightforward. Just like ID, you'll grab each one, and I'm going to use the class headline. Jump into my CSS editor here. Now the difference between ID and class is that you select classes with a period. So I'm just gonna type period, headline, color, blue, and there it is. Got all of them. So the idea of these three sections is to streamline your editing. The cool thing about class is that you can enter multiple classes by simply separating with a space. No need to enter a period or a semicolon. The class box is also where we enter in our utility or helper classes, which are basically just small strings of words that when entered into the class box on a specific element will generate a specific CSS code and apply it to the element. We have a detailed tutorial going over these. A link should be popping up in the video for that right now. Otherwise, I also have a link in the description. The styling section is basically a shortcut for adding custom CSS styling to your elements. And what I mean by that is normally if I was in the custom CSS editor, I would have to type out font-color to change the color of this. Versus if I'm using the styling box right here, all I really need to type is color colon blue semicolon, and that changes the color. So this saves you a lot of time. And you can also enter multiple styles by separating with a semicolon and a space. Now, this may be quicker to enter things in this way, but it's important to know that it's not always the most efficient way to enter in your customizations. And what I mean by that is this styling will only affect the individual element that you place it on. So if you want to add the same font color to multiple elements on the page, it would be more efficient to select all those elements inside the custom CSS editor rather than type everything out three different times inside of the style box right here. Being wise with your selections and styling will help cut down on load times on your pages when you have a lot of CSS. Here's a little example to show what I mean. So say I want to change the color of all the custom headlines on the page. Now instead of selecting every single one of them and typing color blue, what I would do is go into my CSS editor up here, and I'm going to type the generic class selector for your custom headlines. So that would be H custom headline. And I'm going to say color, color blue. And that selects all of them. So you can imagine if you were simply typing in color blue on all of the headlines on the page, it would be a lot more code than just using this one code up here. So if you're efficient with your styling with CSS, you can bring down the load time of your website significantly, especially if you're using a lot of CSS. Now, I'm not really going to go in the nitty-gritty details of CSS in this video. I will leave a couple links to my favorite websites for learning CSS in the description. Now, if you're wondering how I got that class selector for all the custom headlines on the page, since I didn't explain it earlier when I was going over class, all I did was right-click, inspect, find the custom headline element, and select it. And this right here is the class selector. So this is an easy way to figure out what you need to be editing. All you really need to do is copy and paste that, and you can use it in the CSS editor. Alright guys, well thank you so much for watching. Proud of you for making it this far in the video. Please subscribe for more. We enjoy making these videos, and we've got a lot of Cornerstone videos coming up. This video is meant to be a precursor to our upcoming Element tutorial videos. Please subscribe to see those. If you already have subscribed, just remember that I love you. Thank you for watching. We'll catch you next time.